Have you ever wanted to add interactive buttons to your game? Today, we're going to learn how to do just that by creating simple buttons in Pygame. Imagine having a beautiful background image with two buttons, one to start the game and another to exit. Click the Start button and we will print a message to the console. Click the Exit button and we will close the game. It's easier than you might think. Stick with me for the next 15 minutes and you'll have a fully functional, interactive interface ready to go. Let's dive right in. Let's create a new Python file and name it main.py. Now we have to create a simple game loop. If you don't know how to create a simple game loop, please watch my detailed video called Get Started in Pygame in 20 minutes. It will teach you everything you need to know. I will quickly create a new game loop now. First, let's import Pygame. Import Pygame. The next step is to initialize Pygame. We just have to type pygame.init. Now let's create the game window. Window is equal to pygame.display.setmode parentheses and again parentheses 800,600. Let's set the caption for the window. pygame.display.setCaption parentheses quotes pygame buttons tutorial. Next, let's create a clock object. We're going to need it to set the target frame rate for our project. Clock is equal to pygame.time.clock. Now it is time for the game loop. While true, colon. In the game loop, the first thing we have to do is to check for events. Specifically, we need to check for the quit event, which occurs when the user presses the X button on the game window. For event in pygame.event.get parentheses and a colon. If event.type equals equals pygame.quit colon. If the user presses the X button on the game window, we have to close it. pygame.quit and then sys.exit. To use the sys.exit function, we need to import the sys module as well. So at the top of our file, we import it like this, comma sys here. Let's now paint the background of the window black. window.fill parentheses quotes black. Now we have to update the contents of the game window. pygame.display.flip. And finally, let's set the refresh rate of the window to 60 frames per second. clock.tick parentheses 60. Our game loop is ready. If we run the game now, we can see a window pops up with the color and the dimensions we defined. Cool. Now that we have our game loop ready, it's time to add some visuals. Let's load and display a background image to make our game window look more appealing. All the necessary graphic files for this project are located in a folder named Graphics. This folder should be placed inside your game directory. You can download all the graphics, including the background image, from the GitHub repository. For this tutorial, we will use a background image named background.png. Ensure that this image is placed inside the graphics folder within your game directory. To load the image, we will use pygames.image.load method. Let's add this line of code right after we initialize Pygame. Background is equal to pygame.image.load parentheses quotes graphics slash background.png dot convert. Then convert method is important because it optimizes the image for faster bleeding onto the screen. Next, we need to display this image in our game window. We do this by bleeding the image onto the screen surface. The bleed method takes the image and the coordinates where you want to place it. Since we want the background to cover the entire window, we will start at the top left corner, at 0,0. We add this line inside the game loop, right after filling the screen with black. window.bleed parentheses background, comma, parentheses 0,0. If we run the game now, we can see our background image displayed in the game window. It is that simple. Beautiful. Now that we have a stunning background in place, it is time to add some interactivity to our game. We are going to use object-oriented programming to help us organize our code. By creating a button class, we can easily reuse this code in future projects with minimal changes. Let's create a new file for our button class. We press Ctrl plus N to create a new file and then Ctrl plus S to save it as button.py. First, let's import Pygame. Import Pygame. Now we can start defining our button class. Class button colon. The next step is to create the init method which will initialize our button's attributes. Def init parentheses self colon. Now let's think about the attributes we're going to need. First of all, we're going to need an image. So let's load the image of the button. I have placed the images that we're going to use in this game in a folder named graphics inside our game folder. Self.image is equal to pygame.image.load parentheses image path dot convert underscore alpha. And we need to pass in the image path to the init method, comma image path. The convert alpha method here ensures that any transparency in the image is preserved, which is particularly useful for button graphics. Next, we need a rectangle attribute that will enclose the image. This rectangle will help us detect mouse clicks, and it will also be useful for positioning and drawing the button on the screen. Let's create the rect attribute. Self.rect is equal to self.image.getRect. Parentheses. The getRect method returns a rectangle that encloses the entire image. By default, this rectangle is positioned at the origin, 0,0. We can later move this rectangle to the desired position on the screen. The first version of the init method is ready. Now, let's create a draw method that will be responsible for drawing the button on the screen. Def draw parentheses self, window, colon. The draw method takes one parameter, window, which is the surface on which we want to draw the button. Now we can use the bleed method to draw the image of the button. Window.bleed parentheses self.image, self.rect. This line draws the self.image at the coordinates specified by the self.rect on the window surface. Now we are ready to see our button for the first time. Let's go back to the main file. Here is a quick shortcut. You can press Alt plus 1 and Sublime Text will get you back to the first open tab of your project. First, let's import the button class. From button, import button. With the class imported, we can now create a button object. Let's create the start button. Start button is equal to button parentheses. We have to pass in the path to the button graphic. Quotes graphics slash start underscore button dot png. Our button is ready. Next, we need to draw this button inside our game loop. In the game loop, after clearing the background, we just have to call the draw method of the start button object. Start button dot draw parentheses window. If we run the game now, we can see our button for the first time. Beautiful! The button appears at the top left corner of the window and it is very big. We are going to fix this issue now. First of all, let's make our class more versatile. We want to be able to place the button wherever we want on the screen. Let's go back to the button.py file. We can press Alt plus 2 to switch to the second open tab in Sublime Text. Let's update the init method to accept a position. Here is how we can do it. In the init method, we add comma position here. It will be a tuple of two values, the x and y coordinates of the top left corner of the button. Now we have to move the button to the position we get as an argument. All we have to do is to modify this line of code where we create the rectangle for our button. Self.rect is equal to self.image.getRect parentheses, top left is equal to position. This line creates a rectangle for the button image and position its top left corner at the specified x and y coordinates stored in the position tuple. Let's test it. Let's go back to the main file. In this line of code where we create the button, let's also add a position for it in a tuple, comma, parentheses, 300, 150, for example. We are ready to test our code once more. Perfect. As you can see, the button has moved 300 pixels to the left and 150 pixels down. The last thing we have to fix is the size of the image. It would be very nice if we could scale the image of the button to fit our needs. This is exactly what we're going to do now. Back to our button.py file. Let's add another parameter to the init method to handle the scaling of the button image. This parameter will allow us to specify the scaling factor for the button image. Here is how we can do it. In the init method, we add comma scale. We can make this parameter optional if we provide a default value to it. Check this out. Scale equals 1.0. Let's go back to the main file and run the code again. Even though we have not provided a scale, the code works because the scale parameter is optional and defaults to 1. Okay, let's now scale the image. In the button.py file, in the init method, we add the following lines of code. First, let's find the current size of the image in pixels. Pygame makes that very easy. Original width is equal to self.image.getWidth. Original height is equal to self.image.getHeight. Now we have to calculate the new size of the button using the scale factor. New width is equal to int parentheses original width times scale, and new height is equal to int parentheses original height times scale. We cast the values to int to ensure that they are whole numbers. Next, we use Pygame's smooth scale method to resize the image to the new dimensions. Self.image is equal to pygame.transform.smoothscale parentheses self.image comma parentheses new width comma new height. That's it. Let's test it out. Let's go back to the main file one more time. Let's make the start button smaller. So let's make the scale factor 0.65. comma 0.65 here. If we run the code now, we can see that the button now appears smaller in size. Perfect! Our class works as expected. Now it is time to add the click functionality. To detect when our button is clicked, we need to add a method that checks if the mouse is over the button when we press the left mouse button. The method will return true if the button is pressed. Let's go back to the button.py file and add a method called isPressed. Here is how we can do it. Def isPressed parentheses self colon. First, we have to get the position of the mouse on the screen. Mouse pose is equal to pygame.mouse.getPose. Now we have the coordinates of the mouse in a tuple named mouse position. Next, let's see if the left mouse button is pressed. Mouse pressed is equal to pygame.mouse.getPressed parentheses brackets 0. Now, the mouse pressed variable holds a boolean value indicating if the mouse button is pressed or not. Next, we check if the mouse is over the button's rectangle. If self.rect.collidePoint parentheses mouse pose colon. This line checks if the mouse cursor is within the area defined by the button's rectangle. Now we need to check if the left mouse button is pressed. If mouse pressed colon. That's it. We detected a mouse click. Let's return true. Return true. In every other case, we return false. Return false. Our method is ready. Let's test it. In the main.py file, inside the game loop, after we check for events, let's call the isPressed method. If startButton.isPressed colon print parentheses quotes start button pressed. Let's run the code. As you can see, our code works. If I click on the button, the message start button pressed appears at the console. But there is a small problem with our code. The game loop runs 60 times per second, and even though I press the mouse button for a fraction of a second, it registers multiple mouse clicks. We have to fix it. We need to register only one mouse click. We have to go back to the button.py file. To solve this issue, we have to create a new Boolean attribute. Let's call it pressed. So, in the init method, we add an attribute, self.pressed equals false. This attribute will tell us if the button is pressed or not. So, here is what we are going to do in the isPressed method. If the button is pressed and the pressed attribute is false, if mouse pressed and not self.pressed colon, we set the pressed attribute to true and we return true. Self.pressed equals true. Now all we have to do is to set the pressed attribute to false if the mouse button is released. If not mouse pressed colon, self.pressed equals false. Our method is ready. Let's test it one more time. Perfect. As you can see, now our method registers only one click each time we press the mouse button. Now that our button class is implemented, we can add buttons to our game very easily. Check this out. We're going to add the exit button and it will take us less than a minute. Outside of the game loop, we add a new button. Exit button is equal to button parentheses quotes graphics slash exit button dot png comma parentheses 300, 300, 0.65. Now inside the game loop, we check if the exit button is pressed. If exit button dot is pressed parentheses and a colon, if it is pressed, we can exit the game. Pygame.quit and sys.exit. The last thing we have to do is to draw the button on the screen. So after we draw the start button, let's also draw the exit button. Exit button dot draw parentheses window. That's it. We can now run our game one more time. Perfect. As you can see, both buttons now appear on the screen. If we press the exit button, the game exits. Congratulations! You have successfully created and implemented a versatile button class for your Pygame projects. With this button class, you can easily add interactive buttons to any game, enhancing user interaction and control. Thank you for following along with this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful and you are excited to use these buttons in your own projects. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more tutorials like this one, please like, comment and subscribe to my channel. Your support helps me create more content for you. Happy coding, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.